Now we do the analysis of the integral from 0 to 1 of 1 over x to the p. It's an improper integral. And so we can know by graphing, if you graph this and say put a 1.5 in there, which is p greater than 1, you can see from the graph that here's your area from 0 to 1. Looks like there's too much area there. In other words, the curve is not reaching toward the y-axis asymptote quick enough to have the area converge. So it looks like it's going to diverge. So we'll see if that's true. Then over on this one, p is less than 1 at 0.5, and so this graph, here's the area in question, 0 to 1. And so that definitely looks like that's going to converge, because the curve does, looks like it dies into the toward the asymptote quick enough to limit the area down. And of course our x to the first power, which is 1 over x, it's the same as in the, very similar to the previous case, but it's log of 1, which is 0, minus log of 0, and that's infinity. So, actually negative infinity, so negative of negative infinity is infinity, so it diverges. Okay, so the result is p greater than 1, that integral diverges, p less than 1 converges, which is exact opposite from the integral a to infinity of 1 over x to the p. So now we're going to just have to prove all that. Here's your integral. It's the usual limit statement. But a goes down to 0 from the right. Here's your a. So that integrates nicely and ends up being this expression. Then your integral in question is going to be the limit as a goes down to 0 from the right of that expression. Case 1, p less than 1. So for p less than 1, your p is less than 1, so 1 minus that p is going to be a positive number, some kind of positive number. And that's going to just be a to some positive number. And the a is going down to 0, so there's no trouble there. That thing's going to go to 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1. So that's what the area converges to in that case. Not the area, but just that expression converges to 1. So then in the limit, a going to, in the limit, which is a goes to 0 from the plus side, you're going to have your expression here. And you're going to have 1 over 1 minus p times the 1 that that expression converges to. So you're going to have 1 over 1 minus p, which is just some number. And p is less than 1, so it's some positive number, which matches up to the graph, being a positive area. Then for p greater than 1, same kind of analysis. When you're looking inside the 1 minus p, that'll be a negative number up there now. So you'll have a negative number. That means the 1 over a to a power, and a is going down to 0, so that's going to go to infinity. And you want to have 1 minus infinity is negative infinity. And then when you put that in for this expression here, this 1 over 1 minus p, p greater than 1, this will be a negative number. So you're going to have 1 minus infinity because A is some positive number greater than zero, and it's being raised to 1 minus P, so that's a negative number, so it'll be 1 over A to some power, and as A goes down to zero, that goes to infinity. So this part goes to 1 minus infinity, and negative times negative infinity is infinity. But the integral does not exist, and therefore the integral, in this case, diverges. Okay, another interesting integral to compare with is e to the negative ax as x goes from 0 to infinity. Let's put a positive a in here, so it becomes negative 2. 2 is a positive number. And that's going to be like 1 over e to the 2x. So we're thinking that's going to go to 0 very quick, which it does. The function dives to 0 quick enough, very quick. So this area, we think, is going to converge. And then if the a is less than or equal to 0, then like negative 1, so that a negative negative 1 is 1x, then you can see that e to the x, that's just going to explode, and when you add up all that area, it's just going to really diverge quick and going to infinity. So that's what we think is going to happen. It'll converge for a values greater than 0 and diverge for a less than or equal to 0. And here's your mathematical justification of that. Here's your definition form. A nice easy integral right here, evaluated at 0 to b. B is going to infinity. So you have this expression here, which is equal to this. Now, in the case of a greater than 0, the a greater than 0 and the b is going to infinity. That's positive. So this will be an 1 over e to the ab. It'll look like this. And a is just some number. B is going to infinity, so this will go to 0. So you'll have negative 1 over a times negative 1, which will be 1 over a. Definitely converges since a is just a number. In the case of a less than 0, then you're going to have the same expression, except this time, since a is negative, you'll have a negative negative, which means positive because b is positive. So this whole part up here is going to be a positive, and e to a positive number gets real big. And the negative 1 over a, since a is negative, will itself be a positive number, and that's going to positive infinity. So this whole thing is going to go to positive infinity, which means it does not exist. It diverges. So here's a nice recap out of the book, from the Hughes-Hallett book, of the different rules that we've seen. But basically all you have to do is graph a quick example, and you'll be able to tell and remember under which conditions the integrals converge or diverge.